manifesto of liberty as we all basically think along the same lines. And it's that idea that's bulletproof. Here is the powerful audio and video of the confrontation.
Rockefellers, come back. We don't want your new world order, you know? Leave Chile right now. Leave Chile. You are not... You're killing a lot of people! You're killing a lot of people! Leave here! Leave Chile right now! Leave Chile! Leave Chile! We don't want your world government! Leave Chile right now! Leave Chile, okay? Leave Chile! Your family is the most disgusting in the world, you know? Leave here! Leave! Leave! You also, you're a traitor to Chile! Mr. Agustin Edwards, you're a traitor to Chile, okay? You're a traitor to Chile! What you're doing right now, okay? 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 You know everything! You know everything! You're participating with him! You're participating with him in this! Your world government will fail, okay?
It will fail!
Your world government will fail! Will fail! Will fail! You know it! Leave Chile right now! We don't want you here! We don't want your disgusting things here! Leave Chile now!
You gotta love it. We don't want you here, you disgusting creature. And by the way, Rockefeller admittedly ran the takeover of Chile and death squads that conservatively killed tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands were put in prison or disappeared. So here's a guy in a country that still isn't too free talking to a literal Hitler visiting his country who's committed a Holocaust. That's real courage.
Are you tired of searching for great talk radio?
Something more important.
Search no more. We are the GCN Radio Network.
Diamond Gusset is proud to announce the anthem of the Patriot Movement. They're offering a free CD, T-shirt, and bumper sticker with a qualifying purchase. Diamond Gusset offers great products at great prices while keeping Americans working.
I'm looking for a factory where a man can feed his family. Not worried about them moving it south, closing the doors and shutting her down tomorrow. I'm looking for America.
Wear American and be proud. Go to gusset.com/America.
The land of the free and the home of the brave. Seems like I just woke up one day.
gusset.com/America today.
Waging war on corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Coming up in about 30 minutes, we've got conservative icon Phyllis Schlafly, head of the Eagle Forum, joining us to talk about, is it going to be meet the new boss, same as the old boss with these Republicans going into Congress? What do we do about the globalist agenda? I'm going to ask her about globalist control, the conservative movement in this country. How far does it go back? Does it go back to Barry Goldwater or before? We're going to have an important talk with her coming up in 30 minutes. Look forward to that. And then in studio, we're going to have Dr. Wakefield, who's been on all the big morning shows. Good Morning America, Dr. Andrew Wakefield. They're trying to run this hoax that his research on autism, the vaccine link, is a hoax. If you just joined us, I could watch that Rockefeller confrontation over and over again. You see the vampiric leer of Nosferatu, Herr Rockefeller. If you have to point at one man who's been a more tireless agent of Mordor, of evil, it has to be David Rockefeller. I mean, he's CFR, Trilateral Commission, UN programs, biological diversity assessments, carbon taxes, the entire China we see today, this giant murdering monster with sports stadium executions and total control and one-child policies. It was David Rockefeller who went there, set the deal up, writes about it in his memoirs, praises Mao Zedong. Just as... the head of Goddard Space Center, James Hansen, says we need a Chinese authoritarianism. He says totalitarianism is good. And what do we hear from Dr. Eric Pianca, biology department? At least he was the head years ago. I don't know what he is now. What do we have with Peter Singer? What do we have with Ted Turner? What do we have with Jacques Cousteau? What do we have with Prince Philip? What do we have with Prince Charles? What do we have with it? Every day or two, Watson's got a new article where some top IPCC head at the UN says we need authoritarianism, get rid of freedom, carbon tax everyone, one-child policies. And this Hansen goes on to say, we'll have no economy, in Watson's article, quoting him, we'll have no economy until we embrace the Chinese model of totalitarianism and carbon taxes, and that tariffs should be levied globally against the U.S. if we don't go along with it. Meanwhile, China, who he says is the model, doesn't have these carbon taxes. I mean, he knows they're imploding our economy, and now they're going to dance around on the ashes of our economy, blaming it because we didn't accept carbon taxes? Well, California has, and look how fast they're going down the toilet bowl, how fast they're circling the drain. I mean, these guys relish authoritarian oppression. They relish forced abortion. They endorse it. And it's their little enjoyment, their little power trip over you when they go to the mall, and they always write about how they detest their fellow Americans, or when they go walk down the street or they go to Times Square and they just survey the public. And they write about this, how disgusting we are, how filthy we are. But they've got that little power trip. They're not stopping us from what we're putting the Teflon in the pans, that if your parrot is sitting 10 feet from it, it'll drop dead. It's so deadly. They're not going to stop us from that fluoride in that water when we're also putting it in the foods now. They're not going to stop us from the vaccines. Oh, God. Bill Gates, oh, we've given him so much power. He's patenting all these mosquitoes that'll forcibly deliver it. Oh, we're going to sterilize them. We're going to take their power to breed. Oh, we've got this instinct to want to dominate and control you. And oh, we're control freaks. Oh, the religion of control freakdom. They love looking at you with hate. And I've seen globalists, I've read their writings, I've studied them. When they see a family, a good-looking family with healthy, happy kids, they just recoil with hate. And they've always just got, like, black teeth. And even if they're young, they always look like David Rockefeller or this handsome guy. They're always like Emperor Palpatine. I will be seeing the degenerative effects on your children soon enough. I control everything, you fools. You don't even know we're poisoning your water. They'll never wake up. I mean, it's just, why do we let this scum perch on us and vomit on us?
Alex told you the government announced recently that the recession is over. It ended on June of 2009. The millions of Americans unable to find work might not agree. Perhaps the recession ended for the bankers and government employees, but for the rest of us, things seem to be getting worse. Gold and silver haven't heard the news either. They've begun their long-expected journey to the moon. In addition to converting your shrinking dollars into gold and silver, you should consider a food savings account from eFoods Direct. They both make fabulous investments. Food is our greatest dependency, and we know it will be more precious than any financial resource. You and your family need food to survive a crisis, and you can't eat paper, stocks, or metals. Alex has been urging you to invest in delicious, easy-fix meals to enjoy now or save for long-term. This will freeze the cost of your food while you can still afford it. Visit eFoodsDirect.com on the internet or call 800-409-5633. That's eFoodsDirect.com or 800-409-5633.
A very wealthy U.S. citizen is predicting that in 2011, we will witness the most important day in America in more than 50 years. He says it will change everything about our lives. The way you shop, travel, invest, educate your children, and even how you take care of your health and your own family. Now, this man has made some outrageous predictions over the years. The crazy part is, he's usually right. You see, he predicted the collapse of GM, Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac, and America's biggest mall owner, General Growth Properties. In fact, Barron's called his work a dire prophecy. Recently, he created a video, which you can watch online for free, detailing his biggest and most important prediction yet, and it's a real eye-opener. I can't stress this enough. You should at least watch this free video online today. He explains everything you need to know, including simple steps you can take to protect yourself. You can find the video at www.endofamerica3.com. That's endofamerica3.com. Watch the free video at www.endofamerica3.com. That's endofamerica3.com.
VoiceAmerica3.com.
Folks, you've heard us talk about Home Gain before. Home Gain is now offering a special promo where you get up to $150 when you buy or sell a home with a Home Gain agent you find through their Find a Realtor program. Home Gain lets you compare realtors anonymously. It's easy. Go to HomeGain150.com to find and compare realtors anonymously. Enter promo code HomeGain150 and receive up to $150 when you close a deal with a Home Gain agent. Share the Home Gain 150 promo code with your friends via Facebook, Twitter, text, and more. Look for Max, the Home Gain Gorilla, to find out more about how Home Gain is going to pay you. Visit HomeGain150.com today to enter your promo code and get paid for buying or selling a house. That's HomeGain150.com.
He's the T-Rex of political talk. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
During the break, I was watching Fox News. They had on the screen, U.S. owes more than $1 trillion to China. And then it was Obama with hat in hand at the table being bossed around by the Chinese. The globalists have worked so hard to get us into debt. They've worked so hard to overextend us as an empire. While the Rupert Murdoch media overseas demonizes us, domestically it leads the charge of patriotism, leading us into the trap, leading us into the setup. Then the controlled left here at home demonizes America instead of demonizing the globalists that have engineered this. And the vast majority, over 90% of this debt, if not owed because of Social Security or because of even the military budget, it is owed in derivatives because we've signed on to pay off the 1.5 global quadrillion derivatives, 1,500 trillion. And that was a year ago. That's an average of what a group of economists said here on air. Again, the Washington Post a few months ago said 600 plus trill, which would be a little more than one-third of what Tarpley says, 1.5 quadrillion, 1,500 trill. But many other mainline economists say it's over a trill, 1,000 trill. It's hard to even get my mind around these numbers. And some economists say it's over 2,000 trill. See, I can't even say this properly. Many economists say it's 1,500 trillion. The Washington Post says it's around 650 trillion. Webster Tarpley says it's 1,500 trillion. But whether it's 650 trillion or 1,500 trillion or 2,000 trillion, we don't owe it. They talk about our national debt being 14.5 trillion. The national debt is $14.5 trillion. Bloomberg reported over a year ago, it was in January of last year, $28 trillion. In late 2009, they reported $23.7 trillion. You can just say $23.7 trillion Bloomberg. It'll come up for you. Then an additional five-plus trill was spent. And then they stopped giving the numbers. And they won't tell Congress or anybody else. So we owe $14 trillion and change on the Social Security and all the rest of this. But we're signed on in derivatives to over $1,000 trillion. And they endlessly talk about the $14-plus trillion. You know, 14.2, 14.5, 14.6, depending on how you slice it. Why aren't we having a discussion about the 1.5 quadrillion? 1,000.